Was there anything more terrible than something bad happening to a person's children? She'd never have another happy moment in her life. She would always wonder where her children had gone and tear herself apart over the fact that she hadn't looked after them properly. She did her best, though. Two children who hadn't yet started school had to have food and clothing, the rent had to be paid, and every now and then the children had to be given a toy that had been made in a factory and which she would buy in a toy shop. It was lucky that they had their birthday on the same day and could therefore be given just one present to share. When they turned 5, they got a music box with a handle and a lid that you could open. Then a figure would pop up, wearing a white fur coat and a crown on its head, rather like the Snow Queen, in fact. And the music box would play a melody when they turned the handle, and small metal plates hit a barrel with little pins on it. Jonna took the music box out of the wardrobe and turned the handle. She reread her letter to her mother and thought that she would think they had lost their minds. Who could imagine that they had been abducted by a Snow Queen and had disappeared straight into a mirror? No, they must have been kidnapped. A thief had broken in and stolen what little there was of any value and used the occasion to take the children with him on the basis that he could always get a bit of ransom money for them. But Jonna could only tell it the way it had happened. After all, she had seen it all with her own eyes. And anyway, Jonna would be at home when her mother came home at midnight and would hear the whole story then. The letter was just in case anything should happen to Jonna as well. The wind howled outside the window. The street lamp had gone out, and it was so dark you couldn't even see the whirling snow. There weren't many logs left, and Jonna prodded the embers with a poker to get the heat going.